What is up, people? What's up, Victory Life College Ministry? This is the second episode of The Charge.
Except for I'm here now, so it's better.
That's Addison's opinion. You all let her have her opinion. But no, on a serious note, it is absolutely better to have Addison here as well. We're excited that you joined us. This evening. We had a lot of cool stuff that we did last week. Some of you participated in what was our hashtag. Andrew, what was our hashtag?
VLCM Chicken Hunt, as much as I did not like it.
Definitely picked that one myself. That's okay. I asked for their opinion, and they gave me their, but I went a different route. That's okay. But we had a couple of you do the challenge, which, Andrew, what'd they have a chance to win?
They had a chance to win a $15 gift card to Slim Chickens.
You good over there?
What just happened?
I don't know.
In elementary, right, we did this thing. He was like, wow, mom. When it was like her week to bring us cookies or something.
So is Aaron mom or my mom?
I'm not mom. Definitely not mom.
I didn't do the mom part. It was just
Okay. I'm not the responsible one.
That's fine.
So, all right. Well, with that being said, we told you guys you had a chance to win a $15 Slim Chickens gift card. And we have the drawing. And so we are going to draw a name. And you guys are going to get to see live on The Charge who's going to win. So after Andrew draws,
It's a drawing.
Oh,
it's a cat.
I see what you did there. That's good. That's good.
Shut up, Dallas.
Andrew, you want to go ahead and draw for us, buddy?
We need any producer input.
She wins. She wins the gift card.
Haters. Solid joke. Thank you. And the winner of the $15 gift card to Slim Chickens is Mr. Jake Lomax.
Yeah!
Woo! There we go. Way to go, Jake!
That's what I'm talking about. If y'all have not seen his video, you should go to his Instagram because he made a complete video of it. And that's a very true statement that is on that bucket right now. There are a few problems that a bucket of fried chicken can't.
It's not a Slim Chickens bucket.
No,
that's
okay.
It'll be okay.
That's okay. Anyway, Addison, do you have the next part of our show? Let's hear it.
Is the
sound familiar? I was not ready.
That's the beauty of this. It's the beauty.
Love it. Did you put the thing in the forehead?
Okay. Well, hey guys. This owl is going to be placed in the 10:45 live service with Pastor Sean this Sunday. And if you can text us, DM us, whatever, where this owl is hidden, if you find it behind Pastor Sean, kind of in the scenery or whatever, text us where it is, and you will be entered into a drawing to possibly be on this show, The Charge, the next Sunday. So find the owl, my friends. Find it.
Find it. I love it.
10:45. 10:45.
Yes, 10:45.
That's awesome.
At 9:15, join your Sunday school teachers online.
Yeah, they're going to be sending you guys a video. That way you can hop on and hang out with them a little bit. So, for this week, our fun and goofy activity is we're going to play a little game. And it's a game show. This is The Charge game show edition. It's also apparently hat day on set of the Charge. So we all have our hats on.
Every day is hat day.
We would love to see your favorite hat. And so here's our game show. I'm going to ask Addison and Andrew questions. And then first one to grab the cup gets to answer the question. So we shall see.
Who knows?
Not
too far away.
This is the fun. This is the beauty of it. All right, first question.
I'm going to fall out of this chair.
What year was Saturday Night Live first aired?
I don't watch that show.
What's your guess?
It is a guess. 1971?
Okay.
I feel like that's wrong.
Do you want to take a guess?
Yeah. My guess is 1992.
Wow.
No.
Wow. Andrew was the closest. Saturday Night Live first aired 1975.
Okay.
That's pretty close.
So close.
Second question. Close. When was the... I can't even talk.
I don't know the answer to that one.
Rubik's Cube made. What year?
I'm a history major. You couldn't have picked history questions.
78?
Okay. Addison, any guesses?
The Rubik's Cube?
Uh-huh.
Oh. Let's see. He said 78? I'm going with...
Do not Price is Right me.
I'm going with 69.
Nice, nice, nice. Answer is 1974. 1974. Okay, last question, and then we'll move on.
There are only three?
Yeah, yeah. How long should you leave Lysol on a surface to disinfect it?
We're in a time where both of us should know this.
They don't use Lysol. They don't clean their houses.
I do, just not for disinfecting purposes.
I use Lysol mainly because I spill wipes. Stuff.
Yeah.
5, 4.
30 minutes.
Any guesses, Addison?
5, 2 to 5.
It's definitely 10. The answer is 10. If you want to disinfect a surface, you gotta leave Lysol on there wet for 10 minutes. There's your COVID-19 tip of the day, I guess, for and from the charge. So, okay. With that being said, here is how you can also be on the show. We're going to make a game show, is what we're going to do. We're going to send it out to you guys. We're going to make a game show, send out the link. You have the chance to, the winner of that has a chance to enter into a drawing, and then you have a chance to be on one of the episodes of
drawing.
The Charge. So, with that being said, at the end of every charge, we do something actually scriptural and productive. So, productive. Today we're going to talk about Hebrews 10, 24 through 25. You guys know that scripture. But I just want to ask you guys this. How are you guys not giving up the habit of meeting together with people during this time where you're supposed to be social distancing?
Honestly, yesterday I started doing a lot of Snapchatting with people that I know that are not in Lubbock anymore. I was still trying to get together with a few of the people that are here and still social distancing, but, you know, doing what we can to talk to each other and just, you know, feel out how everybody's days are going and things like that, how they're doing, how they're coping with everything, and how they're dealing with being with their families again,
because yeah.
I know that that was hard for me.
That's cool.
Thoughts, Addison?
Can only be there so long.
Definitely texting. Also, I'm the intern, so I can't disappear. You can cut that out, Dallas. Sorry. Just part of my answer. And then, but texting people. And then, since we're doing challenge, I got the chance to catch up with some people that I haven't talked to in a while. So, definitely social media is a tool. Phone calls are a tool. I called a bunch of people last week, and that was really fun just to get to chat with them, call my cousin, you know.
I love it. So here's my challenge for everybody, me included, is this week I want you to write down a list of five people that you normally talk to, that you're normally hanging out with, either going to lunch with them, stuff like that. Can't do that now, for right now. Not that we can't do that ever, but just for right now. And I want you to call or text those people and just ask them how you can be praying for them. Ask them how you can be engaged in their life. What do they need? And just make that list a habit. And again, just like Hebrews 10:24-25 says, let us not give up meeting together. Let's not get out of the habit of meeting together, even though it's not ideal. So this has been episode 2 of The Charge. We're excited to bring you episode 3 next week. Looking forward to seeing and having you join us Saturday night at 6 p.m.
What does Hebrews 10 have to do with this? Oh, the meeting together.
The meeting.
Got it. That was
golden.
That was real
golden.
True golden. And genuine.
That's golden. that's great. I love that. When was the our show? Let's hear it.